Call unto God and He will answer you. Welcome to the sixth day of our journey from wilderness to Calvary. My dearly beloved of God, we have a beautiful story taken from the book of 2 Kings, chapter 20, verses 1 to 6. There we read an inspiring story how God answers Hezekiah. We all know the story. Hezekiah was sick and he was mourning for his sickness. And to add the burden, God sends prophet Isaiah to tell him that there is an impending death that is going to happen to him. And Hezekiah had no other go. Immediately when he heard Isaiah telling him about his death, he falls onto his knees, turns towards the wall and prays to God. Even before Isaiah could leave the palace, God answers through Isaiah. Isaiah comes back and tells Hezekiah, God has increased 15 more years of life to you. What a mighty God that we have, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Call unto God and He will answer. We have two lessons from the story of Hezekiah. First thing, when he heard the impending death, he did not mourn or he did not try to approach people. Rather, his first focus was unto God. He focused to God and God turned towards him. God looked down on him. My dear brothers and sisters, this happens only when we tune ourselves every day to God. Not this doesn't come at a time. This attitude does not come to us all of a sudden. But when you tune yourself every day to God, to listening to God, only then this attitude springs up and automatically you go onto your knees like Hezekiah. And the second lesson that we get from the story of Hezekiah is God is ever ready to answer us even before we call. And that's why we hear in the book of Isaiah chapter 65 verses 24, God says, before they call, I will answer. While they are still speaking, I will hear. Praise the Lord. Before they call, I will answer. While they are still speaking, I will hear. The same words are repeated by Jesus in today's gospel, taken from the gospel of Matthew chapter 6 verses 7 to 15, where Jesus says that our God knows our needs even before we ask Him. And the following, the prayer, Our Father, is taught to us by our Lord Jesus. Well, my dear brothers and sisters, today our focus is not onto the prayer that Jesus taught us, but what kind of prayer that we make every day. When we come into the church or make a family prayer, our first focus is onto our petitions. We make a lot of petitions to God. But the other day, I was reading a beautiful article written by Father George Stephen, the book titled Be Fruitful. There he identifies two kinds of prayer that are found in the Bible. The first one is the prayer of petition and the second one is the prayer of thanksgiving. He says there, in the prayer of petition, I see what I don't have. In the prayer of thanksgiving, I see what I or others have. There's a lot of difference in the prayer of petition and the prayer of thanksgiving. My dear brothers and sisters, in the prayer of petition, I only see myself, what I have, and what others, in the prayer of petition, I see what I and others don't have, and still we long for it, and that's why we kneel and pray and pray. But in the thanksgiving, I am contented with what I have. and therefore I'm happy with what I have, and therefore I thank God. And the second observation that he makes is that in the prayer of petition, our focus is on the receiver. That means ourselves. It is always when we pray for our brother, our sister, or our own self, the focus is on to ourselves. That is in the prayer of petition. But in the prayer of thanksgiving, it is always the giver, the God, whom we focus on to. And the third observation that he makes here is, in the prayer of petition, we always focus on our worries, our tensions, our problems, and on the things that we want, and the things that I don't have. But in the prayer of thanksgiving, we always focus on what we have and or I have. What a beautiful thing, my dear brothers and sisters. And that's why he says the prayer of thanksgiving is a noble prayer where you're not focused onto yourself, onto your needs, or anything else, but your focus is ultimately God, just like King Ezekiah focused unto God. My dear brothers and sisters, let me give you the two examples from the Bible, from the life story of Mother Mary. Mother Mary had so many problems, so many tensions, humiliations. There's so many things surrounded her. In spite of that, you know, she gives thanks to God. She says, "My soul magnifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in my God." What a beautiful thing. She was not focusing herself onto the worries, sorrows, or onto herself. But rather, she's happy with whatever she has. She was contented with whatever she has. And therefore, she was raising her spirit in thanking God. Another example, a beautiful example which differentiates between the prayer of petition and the prayer of thanksgiving. We hear from the parable of the healing of 10 lepers who come to Jesus, ask for the petition, and Jesus cleanses them and says, "Go and show yourself to the priest." All the 10 leave, and among them only one comes back to give thanks to Jesus. And that's where Jesus asks, "Where are the other 9? These 9 were only happy or looking out only for themselves and were not bothered about to thank God or to focus unto God. Only that man who came to Jesus, who focused himself unto God." And I think, my dear brothers and sisters, the Lent is a time for all of us to focus unto God. Be thankful to every situation that is happening in our lives, because nothing happens without God's will in our lives. A person who thanks God always has a dual benefit, because God's focus is on to him. And secondly, even before he could ask, God answers. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, today, as we enter the church, let our first thing be a praise, a thanksgiving to God. If you like this small piece of reflection, kindly share, like, and contribute a small mite to our brother Vijay, who is trying his best to spread the gospel to the whole world. A small contribution of your ₹5 will definitely make a difference in his life. God bless you, and have a wonderful day.